Through this last year, we have seen homeless encampments in Portland swept, while homeless shelters struggle to come up with enough funding to stay open.
Even with those struggles, there are success stories when it comes to homelessness in our state. People are slowly being housed one by one. Some of them are moving into their first apartment in decades.
News Center Maine's Jack Mulman is here with more on what that work looks like today. Jack.
Brian and Amanda, before we tell you the stories of homeless Mainers who have just been housed, it's important to state the obvious that every remedy and story of homeless people here is different, and what works out for some may not work out for others. But that's the complexity that an organization such as Preble Street is up against. We have two stories of formerly homeless people, one man housed in a traditional housing voucher model, and the other finally found a home when he least expected it.
This is my kitchen. It's good size for a one bedroom, you know.
Artie Hitchcock's story is not one that ends here.
So when did you move in here?
About 3 weeks ago.
Nor did it begin here.
I couldn't pay my rent.
For 30 years, he was homeless in Northern California. And for another 8 years after that, he was homeless in Portland.
It sucked, but it was what it was.
At an encampment behind Lowe's.
A lot of times we were hungry and stuff.
Eventually decided that he was done.
I can't do that out there no more. It's too rough, I'm an old man.
He had a housing voucher and a caseworker with Preble Street's rapid rehousing team. Despite this, the process was long, going back to last summer. But finally, in February, got the call.
In the middle, I was giving up, you know, but I was giving up on a lot of things. And Molly got the hopes back.
His caseworker found a match.
How did that feel that first night?
Nah, I was out.
Around Artie's apartment, yeah, You'll find signs of his life before.
I had it when I was homeless. I just collected it.
And his life now. His caseworker, who didn't want to go on camera, told us the success in this case comes from a mix of hard work from Preble Street, Artie's determination to take any place he could, and luck.
You know, I help other people out too that's homeless.
Artie's case is still rare, and all he can do is wait for his friends to join him. Because this is the life of most homeless people. Housing is hard to get, and oftentimes unhoused people just aren't ready for that next step.
A lot of people have the idea that, okay, they're housed, they have a roof over their head, our job's done, it's over, and actually that's really where a lot of the work begins.
And Preble Street's Britt Lashier says that work is where they want to direct their focus.
It is so nice.
Sure.
Yeah, it is so nice.
But sometimes, answers are found right in front of you.
The Hep C's gone, the Hep B's gone.
Kabir Giger not only had those two ailments, but a blood infection that almost required an amputation. He was sent to the emergency room at Maine Med, and that's where he was brought to Preble Street's Recuperative Care Program, a 15-bed facility where homeless people recovering can get the medication and help they need before being discharged back to the shelter or to the streets.
Is it hard to get a success story like this?
Yeah.
Difficult, because not only did Kabir get the medical treatment he needed through the recuperative care program, he was able to transition to a permanent apartment.
This is our third person that has gone into housing first from recuperative care.
It's a rare and fortunate circumstance, but for Britt Lashier, it means so much.
Oh, you have no idea. Yeah, again, when I met Kabir a few years ago, we all kind of have a list in our head of people that we know might, you know, die at an early age. So seeing someone like Kabir get into a place like Logan Place is one of the most incredible stories I've ever heard.
And I came out and I won. I never let them win.
And right now, 8 out of 10 people who stay with the recuperative care program go back to the shelter. Britt says the goal is to connect more people to housing, something she says will save lives.
But like to get out of that survival mode and to start really figuring out what is it like to live life, that's the most amazing part of like seeing Kabir's story, is like just that smile on his face.
And Preble Street says that oftentimes homeless people coming out of a medical emergency are placed in sober living facilities or a recovery home, but those are also in short supply. The nonprofit says it wants more funding for these programs, and they'd like to eventually expand the recuperative care program to other parts of the state. Brian?
Jack Mulman in our studio. So powerful to see them in those new spaces. Our thanks to you tonight.